and sisters, as I bring the family, and then Mr. Bobbitt, and then we will conclude the eulogy. I think it is only appropriate, based on my last conversation, we hear some words of expression from Michael Jackson.
Tomorrow.
Pictures. All right.
Backstage with Michael Jackson, as close to his private world as you could ever hope to get. People are always asking about the man behind the myth. But in this electric moment, is there really any difference? If you want to find out more about the real Michael Jackson, you start here, at his magical launching pad, and let yourself be part of the illusion.
Respect given to Michael Jackson. Relentless Romeo, rest in peace.
You okay, girl?
Michael Jackson is somewhat some type of god with all the people that been attracted from his death.
A high voltage performance wired up to another world. The man they call Pop's Peter Pan is in full flight. If there was ever a pure entertainment machine, you're watching it.
Walks right into the whole everything down there. The star is his star is down there, right? So everyone's walking over there. And I'm trying to just walk down the sidewalk. I'm like, what's going on? People everywhere. And then I find out his star is down there. So,
all right, you have to tell me, Patricia, your favorite Michael Jackson song of all time. Maybe it was your first Michael Jackson song. And you have to tell me where you were when you heard it, too.
Okay, one of my songs that I like about Michael Jackson is I'll Be There. And the reason that I like it so much is because when my husband and I, we got separated, he told me I'll be there.
I've been a big fan of him for at least 20 years.
Wow, so you were a fan even when you were a kid?
Yes, I've always been a big fan of his.
Now tell me what your first favorite Michael Jackson song was.
Oh, I'll Be There.
All of them, ABC, I'm Going Back to Indiana, I Found That Girl.
I Want You Back.
I Want You Back. And the one when I used to slow dance to and stuff.
Oh, I'll Be There.
When I must make a pack, oh, we yeah, must bring salvation back.
Where There Is Love, I'll Be There.
That was the one right there.
That is a good song. Written by Clifton Davis, believe it or not.
Right, from I Love Your Mama.
No, oh, That's My Mama.
That's My Mama, right.
Exactly. Okay. All right, you know what you're talking about.
The Peter Pan figure bathed in blue light. Michael Jackson is truly one of modern music's enigmas. Some say he's a kid who never really grew up. But perhaps his friend Steven Spielberg had it right when he said, "It's a nice place Michael comes from. I wish we could all spend some time in his world."
Then how about the marriage? Trying to bring a woman into his life. Did you notice it was always conditional? You know, we will have sex, we won't have sex, we will be married. Because here's a child negotiating, because that was a commodity.
He's like a laser beam all the time. He always does his homework. I've never ever seen him nervous about anything. I called him just before he went on this show. This is his first solo tour ever. I said, "You nervous?" He said, "No, I can't wait to get on stage tonight."
You know, I don't really dress in character outside of like doing specific events, but even when I do hear a rare negative comment, 2 seconds later, they're like, can I take a picture? So I know they like it. Like, whether they talk trash or not, they like him, and they're going to show it to everyone. So, whatever. Everyone's a fan of Michael, whether they admit it or not.
People from our country are all crying, and some of them actually tried to commit a suicide because of him.
The clichés seem to fall away when you watch Michael perform. When he says he's inspired by things spiritual, you believe him.
Well, it means a lot to me. I just recently lost both of my parents, and now, you know, Michael's a big part of that, helped me through that. Now I lost him, and it's really hard, but I feel like I should show him his last respects. And I've been there before. I've been where Prince and Paris and Blanket been, so I know how they feel.
ずっと仲いい友達のような関係だったから、これからもずっと私たちの周りにいてほしい。そう言いました。何言ってか分からないです。もうずっと私たちは何かあると旅に日本からこっちへ来て。 姿を見て、マイケルも日本によく来てくれて、いつもディズニーランドとかいろんな本屋さんとかで私たちを見れば手を振ってくれるし、握手してくれるしっていう形でいつも接してくれて、そういう親しみのあるマイケルっていうのをずっと見てきたので、もう家族以上のものでしたから。 すごい辛いです。もうそれじゃないです。大丈夫です。喋り出すとね。はい。ありがとうございます。はい。こんなもので許してください。どうもありがとうございます。ネバーランド、私たちなんかがネバーランド行って、それでそれをマイケル見て、サインしてくれたんです。で、ものすごく喜んでくれた。 来てくれたんだねって言って、友達とみんなで行ったんだよっていう話をしたら、本当に喜んでくれて、最近握手、握手にサインしてくれた。すごい。頭で殴る。
Michael's quiet now. When he was younger, he wasn't that quiet. But I don't know, I think the stage might have done that to him.
Avoiding the spotlight off stage for this most wanted star requires some extraordinary escape routes. And in talking to us, Michael at least confirms one of those myths, that he dons disguises to slip unseen into the real world.
Well, you know, I think Michael Jackson was all of the above. I think at times he was happy. I think, and certainly at times, he was despairing.
The song remains the same, but the singer has become far more elusive.
I think he was so exposed from a very early age.
And I wish I could have told him how to protect himself, because he was so trusting. I felt Martin Brashear was just inappropriate on every level. Asking him if he preferred, playing with kids to having sex with a woman. You know, he was inappropriate. I always believed in his innocence. I never, ever, ever, and I would profess it and defend it.
And when you think about the developmental sequence that a kid has to go through, once you have the eyes of the world on you, you're never a normal guy.
Even if his music is not your style, few can resist the Lord of the Dance.
I dance a lot anyway. I've always loved to dance.
So he had to go through all the developmental changes that we all went through, from middle school to high school to college, where we felt awkward, where we felt unsure of ourselves, where we felt like we were pretty hot, we were pretty great. You do all that thing you do that with the eyes of the world upon you, and it'll take its toll.
Like all superstars, Michael has to deal with a plague of allegations about his private life. Headlines which paint him as a weird recluse. Rumors about his supposedly mammoth plastic surgery. About his supposed fascination for bizarre relics like the Elephant Man. How much of it is true?
Ultimately, underneath that mask were people.
He's been called everything from the Frank Sinatra to the Fred Astaire of the 80s. The spotlight has made him music's first billionaire. All that at 29.
Brothers and sisters, as I bring the family, and then Mr. Bobbitt, and then we will conclude the eulogy. I think it is only appropriate, based on my last conversation, we hear some words of expression from Michael Jackson.
What I'm gonna say is brief, but to the point. James Brown is my greatest inspiration. Ever since I was a small child, no more than like 6 years old, my mother would wake me no matter what time it was. I was sleeping, no matter what I was doing, to watch the television to see the master at work. And when I saw him move, I was mesmerized. I've never seen a performer perform like James Brown, and right then and there, I knew that that was exactly what I wanted to do for the rest of my life because of James Brown. But James Brown, I shall miss you, and I love you so much, and thank you for everything, 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 everything.
Tomorrow Pictures.TV.